Let me tell you about fall transition fishing. Besides rhyming like that, transition fishing, this always sounds fun. I don't know whatever. Everyone's got like a different scientific explanation or definition of it. Let me tell you the layman's terms of it. Fall transition fishing stinks. I mean, that's just what it is. Oh. Let's see here. Hold on. I hope he's better. He's fighting pretty good, but I loosened my drag. No, he's no good. Hey, little guy. Just killed my worm there, though. So, it stinks. I mean, it's what it is. It's a point where the days are getting shorter in the summer. It's the end of summer. Or early fall. Today is September 11th, 9/11. God bless our troops. God bless America. God bless all of our victims 20 years ago today. You will have a very difficult time finding fish on one pattern that'll last all day long. It's difficult to find them schooled up. I'm not talking about Lake Erie and places that are huge with massive schools of smallmouth. You'll find them schooled at places like that. But on what say most Americans are fishing this weekend, smaller lakes. They're local lakes. It's very difficult to find a pattern. So what you end up doing, you hear the term of junk fishing. You get a fish like I had this morning. I've caught one on a spinnerbait. I've caught some on this worm. Oh, I think I hooked a keeper. I did hook a keeper. Butcher's bait's coming through with his wacky worm. Very well could be I'll catch a fish in 1 foot of water today and even 20 foot of water. That keeper I caught there was about 7 foot of water with some weeds. What you might find as far as patterning fish is maybe that's the same type of structure. Like it's going to be on weeds, they're going to be on weeds, they're going to be on wood. But then it could be anywhere in all crosswalk. So that's fall transition fishing. Stinks. Got to be diverse. You got to be able to. You got to be skilled in a number of different techniques to try to maximize your opportunities. Oh, and in a fishing tournament, you cannot lose a fish, because getting five is tough to do. Hey, small. Get that little butcher's finesse bait, rig wacky. Hey, took my worm. Let's go catch fish out here. Sitting on the outside edge. These weeds early on, trying to find the better sized fish. It's gonna be a challenge today, but catching fish. Get on the outside edge of weeds, you're probably gonna find some fish. Maybe not the right size for a tournament, but you'll have some fun. See that weed edge? This is from a Garmin perspective. The weed edge is here. These are mostly fish, believe it or not. Some fish, but probably a mixture of small bass and bluegill, but I'm hoping like right there. There you can see them moving. Hopefully, there's one big bass sitting here. I bet I get bit. Told you I'd get bit. Strong size. Trying to be a finesse. Fall transition. You can go power fishing in the morning. You can go finesse fishing in the afternoon. Vice versa. It's transition. Anything can work. Don't expect a pattern to hold up all day long. Fishing stinks in fall transition. But you know what stinks worse than that? Not fishing at all. I'm going to show you what I found on my perspective here. I have to show it. Awesome. Perfect. Picture perfect. You can't find something more picture perfect.
So if it'll stop moving for us here. Right there. Look at this. Weed edge. Those are fish in there. That's what I found. Isn't that nice?
By the way, I need to grow my Instagram account. I need to. I got a link to it down below in the description. Please, let's be friends on Instagram. Please. Let's be friends. Like, start following me. Just comment on my one of my posts. I don't care which one. To say, Andy, let's be friends. And I'm going to follow you too. We'll be friends. fish make liars out of me every single time they can. You know, I was telling you earlier that you're not gonna fall transition. You're not gonna find big schools of them. Making me into a liar. There's one rule about fishing is that there are no rules, and so they're definitely breaking that. I told you, there's only guidelines fishing. But I'm gonna say this isn't a big school of fish per se. It's just a school of fish, and they're small. So I've caught 6 fish off this one little spot. Well, I don't know, 10 minutes, and 3 of them, 2 of them are keepers. Most of them are not. So I guess I'm pretty consistent. By much, but neither the others. You know, these fish are so small, but there's the first good sign. I mean, the first good sign is that I caught a bunch of fish, but finally. Okay, look at their eating. I don't know if you can see that. Eating something in there. And look at the belly. There's a little fish. That belly. It's probably Jim Wheeler. Yeah, Jim Wheeler, he wants to know how to catch fish out here. I ain't telling him. Holy God, you see that? That's a smallmouth with my 9K jig. Transition fishing is tough, but you can still catch good ones. And you've seen now, I've caught a bunch offshore. That bite's kind of slowed down. I'm coming up shallow. That's good fish. And this tournament I'm fishing, that's probably gonna make me pretty competitive out here today. That's gonna be a call fish. Not by much, but it'll call. 9K Elite Lures jig. Put it in front of them, they'll bite. Almost always I go with a black and blue flipping jig. A 9K Elite Lures. Elite Lures. If I switch up, it's to some form of green pumpkin. Oh, in a fishing tournament, you cannot lose a fish. Jigs, I love you. This just made me tough to beat. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Woo! So catching bigger fish during the fall and transition is possible. It's challenging, very challenging. I spent 8 hours today out in this lake, and I caught 8 or 9 keepers, two of them top quality, and those two came in about 2 foot of water or less, probably more like a foot and a half. I really only caught fish on 2 different baits. The butcher's baits, finesse worm, and then 9K lead lures jig. Skipping though that underneath the dock. That jig I talked about earlier, it was a half ounce. Now, let's see, as I won this tournament, I don't know. I think I put myself in a position to possibly win it.
It's the best looking guy in the lot with 12.31 pounds and $150. Mr. Andy Buss.
He got big bass, which weighed in at 4.88 pounds. That's $50 more. And first place is $300 for a grand total.